Yep, we're good, and we're live.
Green, 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 green!
And we already have the green flag right here. And in the lead is... Shoot Racing. For heat number one here at Lorain Speedway. These 10 lap heats will determine in which order they'll be for the main event. And here with me in the booth is Mr. Chris Myers helping me out today. It looks like Mr. Scott going on the outside of Vivian's Racing, and he takes it easily as he can keep it for the last five laps of this first heat race. Looks like there's a backup there in around fifth place. Unfortunately, there looks like some contact there slowing them up, and they won't be able to make it. It's a good battle for the fifth place here in the heat race with Neil, Ichis, and Heron all fighting for that last spot on the last final three laps as Neil hits the sidewall there just a little bit, slows him down, likes to take the high side, keep taking the high side as Heron keeps trying to get down the inside of Neil there, and Ichis right on the outside, and as they're almost nose to tail and back up near the front, God's able to keep it in first place. Heat Racing second, and Mr. Collins scoots his way up past Shoot Racing for third. Now they all make their way back to the pits for the second heat, which includes AJ, Jake Zoll, Nelson Barlett, Dave Soldra, Chris Myers, Mr. Art Palmer, Frank Keane, Brian Milligan, and Ryan Strickland. Of course, we'll let these guys warm up a bit. As this heat race will also determine the order that these guys will be in for the feature. And here we are as they get ready to start off. Alright, and AJ looking to take the pole here in the second heat race at Lorain Speedway.
Green, green, green,
it
green,
goes
green.
Off, and AJ puts the pedal to the metal and gets a pretty...
Alright, yellow flag.
Ooh, and a yellow flag out already in turn three. It looks like Mr. Frankie went off there at the end of the berm, and he has to go back to the end of the pack for this restart. And as you noticed earlier, it was a double lane restart, but for this one, it's just gonna be a single lane. Everybody at nose to tail. for this one as AJ catches up to the pace car. It looks like everybody's already in order. And the pace car should be heading in this time around. As it takes that right-hand turn, AJ leads the field down the backstretch. And you'll see him pay attention. Watching turn three as he puts it to the floor, or he can wait all the way outside into turn number four. Let's see what he does.
Green flag, go, go, go!
And
go.
There it is, AJ's back off, and Jake gets a great start and is almost able to take AJ on it, but Dave Soldier responds and tries to take Jake on the outside and back there, and Dave Soldier almost in the grass, but he keeps it together. Dave Soldier was in the grass and he keeps it together. And these top guys are fighting it out for the last about 8 laps to go now. And AJ able to keep just take that lead he had and stick it to everybody else. That's awesome work by him. The restart, his restart was great. With Jake almost calling it, but Dave Soldier trying to answer back just as he was trying to get to him. And further back here we have Mr. Palmer. Alan Barlett and Myers trying to hold that for the one of the top spots for the future race. And just a few laps to go, as it looks like there may have been some conflict in the back, and AJ is just pulling away from these guys as there, and Dave Soldier goes to the second place, and he is able to keep it and pushes Jake way, way, way back as Mr. Palmer goes on the inside of Jake too to get some of that action. And oh, and Jake hits the back of Palmer. Oh, and hits the back of Myers, also sending him into a light spin. Luckily, he does not bring out the yellow flag as AJ, just a few more laps in Soja right on AJ's tail. Like AJ's tires.
All right,
he's up, and there's the yellow flag. With only 2 laps to go, the safety car comes back out as there's some guys bouncing around there, so it looks like somebody just got hit a little bit too hard and may have gone off the sidewall. But looking for AJ, he only needs to keep this up for 2 more laps. And he'll be able to win this 10-lap heat.
Green flag, go, 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 go!
And there's green up. Dave Soldier looking for something on the outside. Will he be able to get it as AJ defends the inside of Mr. Palmer there? And there are wheel to wheel going down into turn number 3 and coming out of turn 4. And here's the checker flag. And AJ barely takes it. Palmer in second place. And Dave Soldier in second place. AJ in first and Palmer in third. Wow, that was a great finish to a great race. Some hard racing in the middle laps there. Congratulations. Now we're going to take a little break to get everybody ready for the 45 lap feature race here at Lorain Speedway. So stay tuned.
User left your channel.
All right. Welcome back, everybody. So the results are in for the 45-lap feature race here at Lorain Speedway. In pole position, we have Brian Milligan. Second, Neil. Third, we have AJ. Fourth is Mike Bivens. Fifth, Nelson Barlett. Sixth, Collins. Seventh is Dave Soldra. In eighth position, we have Dan Shoup. Ninth, Chris Myers. Matt Eaches rounds out 10th. Art Palmer, 11th place, and Shane in 12th. And that's our 12 car inversion right there. And 13th place is Brian Strickland. 14th, Chris Hebron. Jake Zoles after him. And round out the last four, Armstrong, Nee, Summers, and Watson. And we have Brian here up in front leading the field. Down out of turn number four.
Green.
And there's the green. Oh, and the yellow flag comes straight out. For what reason? I do not know. But Dave Soldra. Alright, so we are restarting that one as there was a... Looks like Dave Soldra wasn't able to get out onto the track. But I'm sure he'll definitely make this one. Okay, it looks like all the competitors are lining up once more to kick off this 45-lap race at Lorain Speedway. We are here with Brian Milligan leading the pack. And they're coming side by side down into turn three. They round that corner of turn four.
Green flag, go!
And he punches it. And he gets a great lead off of the whole entire pack with Neil right behind him at AJ. In third, falls back to third there. And let's get another view as Neil gets a little bit sideways but is able to hold on to his position overall. But holds up everybody, and AJ taking the outside. Looks like Mr. Matthew Eaches got a stop and go penalty for what I am not too sure. And Brian is just running away from the pack here. He is running away, and there's already about a 7, 8, 9 car length from second place. And AJ getting up into second place from third place. And Neil seems to have fallen back into about fifth place right now. Yes, he is in fifth place. Neil is in fifth place starting from second. And looks like there is a heated battle back here with Neil as he's getting past Mr. Scott. Trying to fight for position.
All right, yellow flag. Back it down.
And it looks like there is a yellow flag. Some cars going slow and the pace car comes out. The leader will be catching the pace car. Brian holds on to the first position and he's getting away pretty nicely, actually. Thanks to the guys trying to battle it out behind him, he's able to get into that clear air and keep running. And he's able to put the car wherever he wants, actually, compared to somebody like those behind him, like AJ or Bartlett, who are battling for a position and have to mind themselves of each other. Brian's able to put the car wherever he wants. He's able to choose the fastest line around the track. And the pace car makes that hard right turn off the track as Brian leads the field. One by one, they come through. And AJ looking to the outside. And AJ gets a wonderful jump on Brian there. And will he be able to keep it to the outside? No, but... Oh, he tried to go inside and they touch, and they're able to keep it together. Great stuff, but the two gentlemen behind them, Mr. Soja and Bartlett, also get up to AJ there, and AJ loses quite a bit of ground trying to go for Brian in the first few laps of the post-caution events.
All right, yellow flag.
And yet there is another yellow flag. It looks like... Looks like a pink car, pink vehicle was, pink Supermodified, excuse me, was involved in that one. Not sure who it was. It was must have been Mr. Dan Shoup Racing. So, looks like he's out of it for good. Yes, he's out of it, unfortunately. Now it looks like they're getting this back pretty fast. So overall, Brian is first, Mr. Soldier second, AJ in the third, same as he started, Bartlett in fourth, Scott in fifth, Mr. Mike in seventh position, not forgetting Collins in sixth, Neil in eighth, Palmer ninth, Matt Chiss in 10th position. Strickland 11th, Jake 12th, Watson 13th, Gavron 14th, and Frankie in 15th. It looks like the field's bunching up yet again so they could start lap number 15 of this race. And they come down one by one into turn three, exiting turn four.
Let's see
what AJ can do. I remember him getting a good jump as Soldier gets an excellent jump on Brian there, and he goes way outside. Let's see what they can do, and let's see if AJ could sneak up in there and do what he can do. And Dave is able to get by Brian, what AJ tried to do a few laps ago off the restart. Dave now leads this race as we are nearing lap 19. Man, it just seems like whoever is in front, they just have so much clean air compared to other ones as they get past Summers here, who is now lapped down, that they could just run away with the whole entire thing as these two guys get in side by side. AJ and Bartlett just going at it as they're getting through a lot of traffic here, which definitely put another spin on things. Collins in sixth place, Palmer in seventh, as Palmer goes down the inside of Collins. And will he able to get stick? Will he able to stick that in? Yes, no, looks like he's having a little trouble getting past him because AJ's right in front of him. Oh, and AJ goes up almost too low. Gets kind of into Palmer, but they're able to keep it together, and Palmer does all get right, the position. As a yellow flag comes out, Palmer moves himself in sixth, Collins moves back to fifth, and AJ, unfortunately, goes back two places since the last time we saw him in fifth. He should be in fifth place. Oh, and I didn't even see this Gott coming out of nowhere. Gott coming down from 12th place to now be in the second. He definitely made his way up the field there. And as the pace car pulls off, Dave is about to lead the field off for his first time, with Gott right behind him, and Brian having, I believe, the most laps led so far, or nearly the most, in the third position. AJ down to fifth, looking to increase his chances of getting back to the podium. And what a start. Mr. Palmer pressuring AJ there. Looks like there has been a change of position as Palmer does get past AJ, unfortunately. AJ does not get the best of best starts. Oh, and Bartlett goes off. He goes off, unfortunately, goes way down. He does not pull out the caution, but man, right, that was unfortunate. But a caution does come out. It may have been, unfortunately, for Bartlett, but I am not too sure. We'll just wait and see what happened there. As a excellent restart by Dave, getting off there, not succumbing to Gott during the first few laps of restart. And Palmer's in a pretty good place in fourth position after coming down from more than halfway down the field, being one of the faster guys. He's able to make his way back up.
Green, 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 green!
And there's the green flag. Flag, Dave Soja gets another good restart as Gott follows behind, and Brian third place. In fourth place, we have Palmer, fifth Collins, and sixth AJ, as Matthew might want to have a look down the inside of AJ here. I know they know each other pretty well, so this might get pretty darn interesting. Everybody seems to be making their way as they are, as it seems like they're using up their tires quite a bit, so they may want to start conserving their tires for the last few laps of the race. As it looks like Collins might be setting up for something special there. He keeps taking the outside every lap, and he is side by side with Palmer in turn number four. Let's see what he could do. He should be able to. Oh, and he gets stopped up by traffic, Mr. Somers. Ouch, that was very unfortunate, but racing is racing. As Palmer, it took him a few laps just to get that worked up, and bam, right there, he got stopped dead in his tracks. And it looks like Myers has been passed by Mike, right in eighth place there in the pink livery right there. So Palmer, it looks like he's setting it up once again.
All right, yellow flag.
And we have another yellow flag. I do not know the source. Maybe, not sure, as it looks like Frankie heads back to the pits, unfortunately. Alright, the field lines up once again as there are 15 laps left in this 45 minute feature at Lorain Speedway. Dave Soja was able to make his way down from 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th place up into 1st. That, I believe, was in 12th place, and he's up into 2nd. And Brian right there in 3rd place, he started green, on the pole. As Dave Soja has been getting pretty good restarts so far and has been able to hold up the top 3 guys right behind him as, who was that diving into the middle of the field? Not too sure, but the yellow does not come out. He was able to clean that up before anything was called. AJ going down into 6th place. Getting a little shaken up. There's Mike once again in a yellow livery. And Hebron keeps it clean, and the green stays out. That's good. And Palmer's able. Mr. Palmer fell back. And these guys are racing side by side through every single lap here. This is exciting stuff, as Colin. It looks like the outside lane is actually the more preferred passing lane, which is something you don't really see in road racing, but here at the Oval, whichever way is faster works, I guess, as there's a change of position in the front, and Dave Soldier can look a little bit sideways, really sideways. And
back it down.
The yellow is brought out by Scott and Dave Soldier as they're battling for lead. Good thing we caught that, because that was pretty insane. With only about 11 laps to go in the race, 10 laps to go, just as long as the heat races were, these guys are going to be feeling it. Their tires are hot. They are. I would be exhausted if I were these guys. Doing this stuff lap after lap after lap over 45 laps is something you have to work at, and it takes a lot of skill to be able to do it, and do it as good as these guys are doing it here. So it looks like, unfortunately, Dave is back in 13th place after being on the podium for most of the race. As the pace car pulls off, let's see what Palmer and Collins could do right behind Gott. Gott going into turn number 3, getting ready to start it off for the last 8 laps of this race.
Green flag, go, 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 go!
And there's a green flag as they go down the front stretch. Palmer likes to go to the inside, Collins to the outside, and the two behind them, Myers and Eaches, also battling it out, one going from the inside and one going from the outside.
right, yellow flag. Back it down.
Ooh, and in the final four laps of the race, there's one more yellow flag. And from my calculations, it looks like this might be the last yellow flag of the race. So, what do these top five guys got to do to bring it home? We have Scott, Collins, Palmer, Myers, Eaches, and behind them, we have Bartlett, Jake, Truex, Hebron, and Mike. 11 to 15, Watson, Soja, Strickland, Somers, and Brian rounds out 15th position. All right, this restart's gonna be a good one to watch. Watch for that contact. I know AJ wants to get back up to
green.
Collins riding the bumper guy. Oh, and they bring it three wide. Ooh, oh, and there's flag. Another caution. It looks like they couldn't get three wide to work in that turn. So it one of them went around. It looks like it was. Palmer. I believe it was Palmer who got around in that one, unfortunately. But he may have been able to keep his top five position. Yes. We'll keep bringing it back into fourth. And Myers making his way up from fifth position, I believe, from fifth position to second, as we have three more laps to go. Now this is something interesting. As we they throw the green flag, Mr. Palmer looking on the outside of Collins. It seems like the outside is the preferred line. So, ooh, and Collins gets turned around and has to join the back of the field as everybody in front keeps going. The yellow flag does not come out. Scott leads the way. It looks like he might bring it home, and he brings it to the finish line and. There it is. There's the finish. Scott brings us home in the first place. Myers second. Palmer in third position. Chiz is able to make his way up all the way to fourth. AJ in fifth. Great job bringing it back up. Bartlett sixth. Evron in seventh. Jake third. Watson ninth. Whoa, excuse me. Evron seventh. Jake in eighth. Watson in ninth. And Mike. In 10th, and Collins in 11th place. Great job, guys. Alright, stay tuned as later in the night we'll be at Sandusky and you'll be able to join us right after qualifying for that race. Two heats, 10 laps each, and one future race of 60 laps. Hey guys, how you doing after that race?
Tired.
Yeah, that's a good one. I bet you guys are. Shane, after coming down from 12th place, how are you able to get it all the way up to first place in those 45 laps?
It's all tire strategy. You know, you run your practice, you know what your tires can do, lap times you can do to make your tires last, and those are the times I tried to do, and so I just picked them off as I could.
Yeah, that is great showmanship back there. You're able to take it away from Mr. Brian Milligan. And Palmer, I saw you had quite a few battles out there with, I believe it was Collins. And if I'm not mistaken, it looked like the high side was the passing lane for this one.
Yeah, I would agree. It's really tough to get by someone when they're up top because they get that run off the corner and you're just hoping to not pinch them off up against the wall.
And so, Myers, what do you think about this race? How were you able to adapt to the situation that was going around you?
I'll tell you, it was tough. I got into somebody, thought they were clear. They moved down. It was my fault. I should let them have the spot. But I had to restart tail and just had to work my way up. And like Shane said, pick cars off as you could get them. And like Art said, the high side was the preferred line for me. And I just had to use the tire strategy and know what the car had left in it. But hats off to Shane and great run for Art. And thanks to all our guys for showing up and supporting the lead.
Yeah, thanks, guys. That was a great race to watch from up here. Lots of stuff going on up in the front. And I'll see you guys next time at Sandusky later on tonight.
We'll be ready. Thanks for all you do.
Thank you.
There you have it. Top three. The podium of this last race, bringing it together. What a great job. I would not be able to do anything like that in a million years, maybe two. And that is a great showmanship by all of them. So here we are for qualifying at Sandusky Speedway. And this track is a little bit different as I believe... Let's see how it is. I believe... Is it a tad bit bigger? Either a tad bit bigger or a tad bit smaller. I don't quite remember, but it is definitely a different track, and it might require some different tactics to get around the guys. From what I saw earlier in practice today, as we watch qualifying here, the guys prefer the low line all the time, so in the race, don't expect too many people to try to take the high line pass, but to scoot in right inside in turn number 1 or turn number 3 to get that low line. You see there, as he just comes around, you will be able to see the grass on the inside. Now that grass is not deathly slippery, but you could, if you get a tire on it, you may be able to use it to get past your competitor. If he leaves that much space, then if you can go for it and make it, you might be able to get him. And I learned from last time here, Mr. Gott finishes up his laps, brushing the wall on the outside there, using as much track as humanly possible. And he's able to put it into second place, with Den first. And we're going to wait for Neil here to do his four qual laps. So right now on provisional pole is Dan. Let's see if Neil can take that away from him, as all eyes are on him. Clips a little bit of the inside grass there, clips the outside wall a bit, but that doesn't slow him down, does it? He keeps on going. Alright, there is the end of qualifying on pole position. Actually, then again, we have two heat races. This is not like road course racing, guys, I'm sorry. But we have two heat races, each 10 laps. We're going to split the field right in half. But the fastest man of qualifying here, Dan Shoup, with a 13.334. And it looks like the entire field separated by less than a second. Amazing stuff. The competition here is extremely incredible. I would not be able to even get near these guys ever. It's just amazing. What these guys do is amazing. These cars are so unique, it definitely requires a certain skill to be able to drive them like these guys do. It's amazing. The second fastest, Mr. Gott, the winner of the last race, Chris Myers, is third. And the time between Gott and Myers, look at that. Look at that. 1/5 thousandths of a second. That's amazing stuff. That's definitely not luck. That is skill by both of those two guys. Alright, and we're going to wait a while as the drivers get ready for their heats. Like I said, each 10 laps times two heats. Oh, the beautiful night sky. Alright, we could watch as the drivers warm up. So here at Sandusky, instead of the 45 laps at Lorain, each lap being about 11 seconds according to qualifying, here at Sandusky with 13 second laps, gonna run 60 laps for the race. Now when that comes up, that's gonna be a showstopper, because if those guys had to manage their tires in the 45 lap race, what are they gonna do for the 60 lapper? It's gonna be interesting. I've heard you're gonna see some people going down to the back. They're gonna be going down to the back to save their tires. And what does that do for them? Whenever they choose to, 30 laps into race, 40 laps into race, they can make their way back up the field. Everybody else's tires are dying, but they'll be able to push on, make those passes on the outside, which seems like it might be a little tougher here to pass on the outside. Thank you. right. Here in the Heat 1 lineup, we have Art Palmer leading the field in first position. Mike in second, Barlett in third. In fourth place, we have Aegis. Myers in fifth. Dan in sixth position. Watson seventh. Frankie in eighth.
Green, 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 green.
And there it is, Brian Milligan. In ninth place, as he already gets an edge. Aww, he takes two positions in the first turn there. Nice job with that one. Palmer's able to keep the pole position. Barlett moves up one position off the start, getting in front of Mike. Excuse me. Oh, and each is able to make his way up. Did you see that? Out of nowhere. Let's check out the wide cam here, because there's action going up and down the field. And down there in sixth place, Myers makes a lunge as there's contact between Barlett. Ooh. Contact between the two pink liveries. We have there Mike, and who else was a part of that? I do not see them at the moment, but as we were looking there, we had two vehicles make contact in that turn that they're coming by right now. Oh, hey there, AJ, welcome to the booth.
How's it going?
It's going good. And this first heat race of Sandusky is already getting pretty intense. It's pretty hot.
Yeah, the heat races here are pretty much like that. Yeah, I think Bivens is getting his spot back.
So Pivens down in fourth place after starting from second, and Aegis in third place starting from fourth after a pretty darn good start at the beginning of the race. All right, we have Palmer coming to
green, 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 green.
The green flag. And he gets an excellent start out there at the, ooh, and more
right,
contact. Ouch, between
down.
The top three guys. Hmm. Did it look like each just came down on him, or what happened there?
I just saw Bivens coming around. I was flipping through the view, but all I got was Bivens after contact.
Right. Man, this one's becoming a free-for-all here. This heat race is scheduled for 10 laps, about 7 laps to go.
D Sideways was the beneficiary there. He's up to 4th place.
Yeah, that's right. B Sideways, also known as Brian Milligan, starting actually in the final position of this heat race, up in 4th place, as you said. That's pretty good for him. And if you remember from the Lorraine feature race, he's actually in the front for quite a majority of the lap for the first half.
Oh, Myers around.
Oh, no. Able to take a spot there again?
Yeah, you get it up.
Green, 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 green.
And there's the green flag as these guys try to complete the last 6 laps of this heat race. Ryan looking to work his way up from the final position as here in the... Let's go. Last position, Mr. Watson trying to get past Mike there once again. Mike's having a tough time here, as is Dan. The pink livery's kind of getting beaten up, pushed around at this track.
All right, yellow flag, back it down.
And another yellow flag. It's time from...
Ryan Sigley puts it on the trailer with suspension.
Now that's unfortunate after getting from, what is it? Down from 10th place all the way up to 4th. Having to see that within the last few laps.
Bartlett's got a faster lap with a 13.812 compared to our leader Art Palmer's 13.904. He just has them both with a 13.809.
Ooh, and there's more contact in the field with the
Shoup and Myers.
Ooh. Yeah.
Green flag, go!
Yeah, and there's a green flag. They're still going. I have a feeling the top three, something's going to come of this one. It seems like it's pretty difficult to pass on this track on the outside. Haven't seen too many people mess up for an opportunity on inside yet in the top here.
He just looks on the low side, he barked into the wall. Just
nudges them up.
It's a run, nothing there.
Good race. Yes, that was a great race as Palmer takes it in the first heat race. Bartlett third, Eaches fourth. Eaches third, Frankie fourth, Myers in fifth position, Watson sixth, and Dan in seventh.
Alright, Darian, thanks for your time. I'm off to my
E.
Appreciate it.
Alright, AJ, good luck. See you out there.
Thank you.
So that is AJ Truex, who will be starting this race in 7th position, this heat race in 7th position, total of 10 laps once again. And in this one we have Mr. Brian Strickland 1st, Dave Soldier in 2nd, Jake Zolan 3rd, Mr. Collins in 4th position, Avron in 5th, got 6th, AJ, as I mentioned, is in 7th place, Neil in 8th, 9th is Dave Armstrong, and rounding out is 10th, Mark Thomers.
Green flag, go!
And they're off. Oh, and there's already contact in the
all
back
right,
there.
Yellow flag, back it down.
The yellow livery, I not remember who that is. That is Jake. As Jake Zoll, after starting third, gets almost mobbed at the beginning of the race here, this heat race, and gets spun around. Possibly having to take it up at the back. You know, it's really hard. You start so high in one of these races. It's only 10 laps. You think about it. It's only 10 laps. If these laps went straight for 10 laps, that's less than a... Thank you, Chris. That's less than a 5-minute race. Now, Chris, you've been racing tonight. How do you handle a race this short? What's your strategy that you have to use? How do you have to think about it?
Well, you know, as we're getting ready to go back green racing for the heat race, you just got to get yourself up into the top fourth position. It could be an 8, 10, or 12 car inversion, so you really got to play it by ear and sort of get yourself in the top four and then hope it's either an 8 car inversion, but then if you're 5th or 6th in the heat, I hope it's a 10 or 12 car inversion.
Green flag, go!
Green flag's backed out, and Soja wastes no time. The veteran stymieing the rookie, Brian Strickland. Soja the outside, he is your new leader. Strickland in for second, Rory Collins third. Shane Dodd, last winner, feature bet. Fourth, Chris Hebron, son of legendary racer Doug Hebron, is in fifth as Dodd goes to the outsider. Collins blows by him like he was standing still. Dodd is now third. What a run so far. You're nearly going, Darian.
Yeah, that's an outstanding start by Dave Soldier. They're just blasting by Strickland. And as he leads this race with only about half of it to go.
Halfway in here at heat race number 2. We're on so many heats tonight, lost count with 2 double shows. But Soldier, the veteran, Strickland, a newcomer here in the Supermodified division here at Up in Smoke, and doing a great job so far. Holding off Shane Gott, another wily veteran here, is Chris Hebron trying to get to the outside of Rory Collins. He gets a little sideways.
All right, yellow flag, back
Hebron.
It down.
Truex in for 6th. And I believe caution is out on the racing surface. That could be for the 9 machine, the 9 ball of Jake Zoll into the pit area.
Yeah, with a third place start there, Jake Zoll. Fortunately, he was got into a little bit of trouble in the first few laps of the race, bringing out the first caution. Looks like he wasn't able to get that together, unfortunately.
Nah, he'll have a 60-lap feature event. This is going to be the longest feature event we've run so far. Going into next week's, I believe next week, it's 75 or 100 laps that the famous Oswego Speedway in Oswego, New York, right off of Lake Ontario, the home of the Supermodifieds, as Soja, Strickland, Shane Dott, Rory Collins, Chris Hebron, AJ Truex, Dave Armstrong in for 7th, Neil Wiegand in for 8th. We're getting ready to rock and roll.
Green.
5 laps to go, heat race number 2.
And as they take off, Hebron loses one position and is under heavy
pressure from Armstrong.
As they bump there in turn number 2 there.
Oh yeah, no arm, no problem. They'll keep going. Soja turning a lap in about 13.724, fast lap for Soja.
And it looks like Gott has a run on Strickland there as he passes him. Strickland into the wall.
Oh,
ouch!
Leg. Back it down.
That is a tough break for Brian Strickland, riding so well here. Turning a fast lap of a 13.724, and got the veteran, pulled the move on Strickland, and I don't necessarily know if Strickland was expecting it here, as we're under caution again with heat race number 2, 2 laps away from the finish. One of these things here with the tires and the Supermodifieds, going under a caution, the heat cycles will really play a big role as you see some guys get loose on the restarts. That's one thing to look for, is guys trying to conserve tires, and if you mash the gas, you might get a little sideways.
Yeah, that's right. As earlier today, I was trying these things out, and I do not see how you guys do this lap after lap after lap. Even with new tires, I couldn't even keep these things straight.
Yeah, that's actually one of the rules. We are not allowed to pit for tires. You cannot pit for tires. Real Supermodifieds don't pit for tires, so we try and enforce
green,
that
green,
rule
green,
as well.
Green, 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 green,
green! As on the restart, Hebron looks to the inside. It has to let off the gas. Battle back up front, though. Dave Soja. Soja and...
Ooh, God. I believe he lost one position, if not two positions, before he's able to cross the finish line.
Got sideways again. AJ... Yeah. Truex finishes second. Rory Collins fourth, and Dave Armstrong fifth.
Yeah, that was a great final two laps there, as a lot of people were pushing as hard as they can. Fortunately, got just pushed a little bit too hard and was able to let AJ through at the finish line.
We'll see if we can get an interview with Dave Soja and Art Palmer coming on down. And we're joined here in the broadcast booth by winner of heat race number one, Art Palmer. Art, congratulations.
Thank you.
How's the car here for you, Sandusky? Not a good qualifying run. Started you up front here in the heat race up in the front, but 60 laps on tap, the car in the heat race, and how do you expect that to transition to the feature event?
I think it's going to be pretty good. I put a lot of practice into this track. It's all about letting your car roll and picking the throttle up slowly off the corners to save your tires. And it's gonna be tough. It's a long race. Got a lot of tire wear.
What is your race strategy here for the feature event? Do you plan on dropping through the pack to the pack, or do you plan on working your just starting up front and staying up front?
I don't know how it's gonna work out. What the inversion is going to be, but if I start up front, my goal is to get out front, set the pace that I want to run, and because I know about what that pace is, so that'll save my tires, that'll make the whole 60 laps. So that's my plan. If I'm out front, I'm going. If I'm middle of the pack, I plan on probably just riding around and hoping to pick them off.
Well, we'll see if we can pull it off here in victory lane by the end of the race tonight. Palmer picking up a feature win at Toledo. You have any other people you want to thank?
I just want to thank the Up and Smoke Racing for putting this on, and all the guys showing up, making this a fun night of racing.
There you go, Art. Best of luck to you in the 60-lap feature event.
Thank you.
Art Palmer, ladies and gentlemen. Now we're joined by heat race winner of race number two from Amherst, Ohio, Dandy Dave Soja. Dave, congratulations. That wasn't an easy heat race to win.
I knew the guy that was chomping at the bits at the end was the guy that I had to worry about. Must have got a little loose at the end. Cars, okay, not great. Just try to get a good pace and see where we end up in the A main. Try to do a little better in the last race.
Yeah, you had a tough race at Lorain County, putting a little dent in your points battle here, but we've got three big races left, starting with Sandusky tonight, Southern National next week, and Oswego Speedway next weekend. Just the way the doubleheader played out, is Up in Smoke Racing will be going to single shows next season. But what do you expect for this 45-lap or 60-lap feature event? You plan on really going from it at the start, set your own pace, or do you just plan on dropping through and seeing what happens?
Try to get up front, but not run it as hard as I did the last race. Try to, if I can get up front and lead some of it, just try to stay out of trouble. If I fall into the middle or back, I'll just try to ride for a while.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Dave, best of luck to you at the feature event. Do you have any people or sponsors you want to thank?
DNS Billiards and Up in Smoke Racing for putting on this series. And Darren here for announcing and broadcasting it.
There you go. Dave Soja's going to be a busy man. He's got to go get your feature race lineup here to go for the 60-lap main event, one of the longest we have here in Up in Smoke Racing. And Darian, I'm going to go get that car finalized and fixed up for the feature event. Hopefully the crew got to work on it.
All right. We'll be watching from above. Have a good race.
Thank you.
And that was Chris Myers. Will be in the feature race. Hopefully be battling it up for the top spot. Now this feature race at Sandusky, as he said, will be 60 laps, much longer than the 45-lap race that was featured previously at Lorain Speedway. All right, here we are getting ready for the feature race at Sandusky. 60 laps are about to commence as Dave Armstrong is in pole position with Neil behind him in second place. Third is Frank Keane. Fourth, AJ Truex, having a strong race, finishing the second race in second place. Fifth is Mr. Palmer. Sixth is Dave Soja. Seventh is Mike Bivens. In eighth position, Bartlett. And ninth position is Roy Collins. 10th position, rounding out to position, Matthew Eaches. 11th, we have Chris Myers. 12th, Mr. Shane Gott. 13th, Watson. 14th is Dan Chu. 15th is Hebron.
Green flag, go, 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 go!
And there's Green Flag with Brian Strickland, 16th, and Jake Zoll in 17th position. And Armstrong gets a pretty good start off of Neil and Palmer. Everything is bright and okay as everybody is still going 3-2 wide after this two-wide start. And, oh man, what a move! As Frank puts it up to the side of Palmer there. And it looks like these guys battling right here, right in the middle of the pack. Mr. Soldier, then AJ got. Oh man, they're battling hard in the opening laps of the 60 lap race. I totally thought they would be taking it a little bit easier. Here's some tags for you guys at home so you know who's who. With Armstrong leading the way, Neil in second place. Got. Oh,
all and right, a yellow flag. Ooh. Back it down.
Ouch, and it looks like got spun there. Who was that? Frankie there got spun, unfortunately. Frankie not able to, and he's not moving. Frankie's there. He is. There he goes. He looks like he is okay. Ooh, and from the looks of it, you might have some. No, I thought he had some suspension damage, but it looks like he'll be able to carry on. Thankfully. Hopefully he could catch himself back up to, yes he does, he catches himself back. So, he will resume the race in 17th position. Luckily he's still on the lead lap. And we're gonna try to keep an eye on Mike here. See, Mike currently in 8th place. I think he'll be doing some great things this one. And as the standings are, Palmer moved up 2 positions.
Green.
And as the green flag drops, Palmer already moving up another position. Oh, AJ trying to get back.
All right, yellow flag, back it down.
And looks like Mike got into the. Unfortunately, Mike got into it once again. That's the start. Might have lost a few positions, but he's able to carry on, which is a good thing. Now, I'm pretty new at this whole super modified thing, but man, are these cars incredible. They are ridiculously awesome, ridiculously fast, super powerful, and get this, they only have one gear. And I believe that gear is called forwards, or fast. No joke. To start these babies, you have to start them by pushing them with a truck, or pulling them with a truck, from what I understand. and then you just start it up and they go. No reverse, no nothing. It's, these cars are one of a kind. One of a kind. It's amazing. So, the safety car going past the start-finish line here. As Armstrong holds on to the first position in the first 11 of 60 laps.
Green, 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 green.
All right, there's the green flag. Armstrong keeps it together, and there is good stuff happening in the back here as Ichison and Watson getting at it very close together, fighting for that 8th, 7th, and hopefully 6th spot. Looks like Mike fell back a bit after some contact, and they are bunching up at the front, bunching up heavily. But they are keeping position as Palmer gets past Neal, and Neal trying to make a move on the inside. Let's see what he can do as AJ kind of taps the wall there. And man, is this some racing up around the fifth position as Pat goes 5-6, 5-6 as he tries to get back at Dave Soja. Neal, sorry, must have been a little bit of lag there. Looks like got hanging about on the outside,
right, flag,
waiting for a move, and there's the yellow flag as Watson, a little bit squirrely, but is able to continue on, thankfully, and the field will gather back up for the single line restarts. As the pace car makes its way through the field. That was a great one through about halfway in the field. A lot of guys bound for it. Ichis, Mike, got Soja with AJ leading that battle. That was amazing. Armstrong in first place. Palmer in second, making his way from fifth. Third, Neal. Fourth, AJ. Fifth, Dave Soja. 6th is, forgot, 7th, Ichis. 8th, Hebron. Oh, 8th, Hebron. That is something, because Hebron came from 15th position all the way up to 8th place. He's doing an excellent job in this race. Hopefully he could keep it up there as we have about 40 laps to go. So, Mr. Collins in 11th place, Strickland in 12th, Myers in 13th, Jake 14th, and rounded off is Watson in 15th position. Let's see if Watson can bring it back up the field, which I think he can. I think Watson can. There's over 40 laps to
go,
and anything can happen in this race. We're taking a look to the inside. Looks like Gott's trying to make his way up through the field. And got Dave Soja side by side in turn one. Dave Soja goes past, and Dave Soja's forced to the outside as Gott takes the preferred line on the inside lane. And there is still side by side. Dave Soja getting a great entry. Great exit, and goes crazy. Neal does. I think he got hung up on the fence there. Gets pushed way down the pack, does not bring out the caution. Thankfully, Palmer putting pressure on the leader, Mr. Armstrong there. Got pushing his way through the pack, is now up into third position. AJ keeps it steady at fourth position. Dave right behind them, and these guys are battling it out. And Mr. Shoup looking for an opportunity here. As they go bumper to bumper, Hebron, and out in turn number 4, Dave is able to get task done. Nice job by Dave. Ouch. Goes a little bit wide and brings out the yellow flag. Dave able to get past. But the response did not work as well for the other driver as he rejoins the track now. And that was Dan Shoup unable to answer back to the overtake. So AJ is still sitting very nicely in fourth position. AJ does have a pretty strong first half of the races that we saw earlier today in the rain. Let's see if he can keep it up for the later half of this race.
Green.
And there's the green flag as they come down into turn number one. Already, man, these cars are fast down the straight. Once you're on the gas, you're going so fast that you have to get right back off it. AJ holding his position there in fourth pretty well. Looks like Gott may be looking for an opportunity here as he takes the inside line down the straightaway. Need to get under Palmer, maybe not. Palmer gets...
All right, yellow flag. Back
and there's
down.
Another yellow flag. Everybody's slowing it down a bit. Looks like Gott has a plan to get past Palmer there, but not enough laps to get that into action. Let's see what comes of it in the next 20 laps or so, because once we get a pretty good green flag run, we'll be able to see guys start building up their plans, building it up lap after lap, and eventually make the move. And when they make it, it's gonna be big. Alright, the pace car pulling off, making that right turn to the pits.
Alright, go!
Let's see what Gott has for Palmer in this next run here. And looks like Dave Soldier might make a move as Matthew Eagles makes a move.
Alright, yellow flag, back it down.
But we only get to about a lap done till the yellow flag does come back out. And the rules are, if you draw a yellow flag, then you're going to the back of the pack. But don't worry, because as we've seen from Hebron here, he's made his way from 15th and he got all the way up to 7th. So it's not the end of the world if you do go to the back of the pack. There's definitely a large number of laps to be able to catch back up, fast people, put plans into action, and get your car where you want it to be. As we look forward to this restart,
green,
passing the halfway point. Excuse me, not the halfway point. We'll have 40 laps in the books by then. So we've already passed the halfway point. This guy's tires are deteriorating lap to lap. Everybody getting a decent start. Each is looking to pass AJ somewhere, somehow. AJ breaks a little bit late. Each is running on him. And it looks like is staying in line. Oh, and there's some action back here. La, la, da, da, da. As Collins and Mike switching places one at a time. Forward and back as they go side by side through the corners. Great job by them. And Colin looks like he's getting away, but Mike trying to answer the call. And does it look like, has Palmer tried to make his move? For a few laps there, Gott and Palmer were side by side. And Palmer unable to make his move on Gott. Armstrong leading the way, but it's amazing that these two guys behind him in the white liveries, Gott and Palmer, are able to battling and keep the same pace as Armstrong there. And AJ going a little bit wide back here, as you can see, and each is almost putting his nose down there to pass him. Oh, and as Hebron makes his way past both of them, but isn't able to keep it. Ooh, and gets a little... That's a nice move by Hebron. Almost passing a few guys. All the way up in 6th place from 17th. As I said, this guy is showing his stuff. Showing his stuff, and it is good. And with Dave Sodra not having the best race so far down in 17th place.
All right,
place,
yellow flag, back it down.
And off the course goes Mike, bringing out the yellow flag. And it looks like Gott has passed Palmer since the last restart. He's able to put that plan into action in those last few laps. Took him about 10 laps to put that plan into action, but he got it. Got it before the yellow came out, which is good. Hebron moving himself all the way up to 6th place there, passing Dave Sodra. Collins in 8th place, Myers in 10th, Jake in 11th. 12th is Mike, 13th Strickland, 14th Bartlett. And that is Bartlett rounding it out for all those on the lead lap.
Green, 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 green.
And as I take a little drink from my water bottle, looks like Ebron, a little slip up, gave away a few positions, but he's still on it. That may be an indication of the tire wear that's going on right now. With only 12 laps to go, this 60-lap series here, people making a move side by side, the number 8 car. And looks like these guys are the one that might benefit from it the most right now. As the rest of the field going wide is Watson. Being lap traffic, Armstrong in second position.
All right, yellow flag, back it down.
I believe. Yes, got Drax in third, able to keep it in third. Each is fourth, Palmer being able to move up to fifth position. From earlier. Ooh, and ouch. Fortunately, Ebron dropping all the way down to 14th place. Not sure what happened, but maybe his tires may have fallen off. I'm not quite sure. This has been a pretty, pretty long race. And these guys' tires have to be on the edge right now. But it's going to be interesting what they can do in these last 20 laps. Excuse me, the last 11 laps of this race. And it should be a good one. Guys getting ready, getting amped. 11 laps. That's the length of the heat laps, so expect these guys to try to run that same pace, try to sprint to the end of this race and take the win. Alright, we have got on in first place here, Armstrong, AJ.
Green flag, go, 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 go!
And there it is. What a great start, but. Ooh, and.
Alright, yellow flag, back it down.
No! No. Unfortunately, before your whole lap can be completed, yellow flag came out. It's like, some people just got tangled up there. It's Collins. Gets back, catches back up to the pack. But it's okay, looks like everybody is still on track. These guys are doing a great job. 10 laps to go. Will AJ be able to keep or stay in the third position? Will each just try to make a move? I remember in the last race, each just was right behind AJ at Lorraine during a few laps. And man, was that intense. Each just trying to go down the inside of AJ a few times.
Green flag, go, 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 go!
Ooh, and Mr. Myers going down the inside. I believe he's able to get it. Ooh, what is going on here? A ton of stuff is going on. Wow, this last 10 laps, insane. Bumper to bumper, door to door racing as Palmer goes back about one or two positions. Getting passed by Myers and Soldier there. Got first position, Armstrong second. AJ in third, each is in fourth. Dave Soldier moving up, moving his way up to fifth. Palmer going down to sixth after actually passing Myers this This is just last lap. Ooh, and right, as AJ flag, gets a little sideways out of turn number two. Not sure if that was his sister or not, but that's what happens when your tires go off. With six laps to go, AJ down from third position. That is insane. Let's see if he can get his way back out there. See if he get his way back up the field.
Flag, go, 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 go!
And this green flag has got, takes it in front of Armstrong, got...
All right, yellow flag, back it down.
Leading the majority of the last half of the race, with Armstrong in the majority of the first half of the race. There's another yellow flag out with only five laps to go. Now, based on the last race, I think Dave is going to try to make a move on each of these last few laps. But not just any move. Move for position, of course. Of course he's going to make a move for position. It looks like Gat has too much pace for Armstrong, and Armstrong too much pace for Eaches, but that little 3, 4, 5, 6 Myers, Palmer, Soldier, and Eaches, that's where it's gonna be. Alright, the pace car is in. Got takes it out of turn two, down the back stretch. And it looks like maybe for the last time we will take it into turn three, out of turn four for the green flag.
Green, 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 green!
And these guys are ready as Got gets a great start. And Myers takes it wide. Try to get off. Oh, and he spins it! No, no! And he is spun out. It looks like, I believe that was Eaches, who unfortunately had the spin. What did I tell you? What did I tell you? No, that's AJ. Is that both AJ and Eaches? Yeah. Definitely. Man, that is unfortunate. Looks like Dave putting himself at the back of the pack as looks like he's taking responsibility for that one. Man, the last three laps of the race can change in the blink of an eye. Palmer coming down from 7th place, starting in 5th, and getting back up to 3rd. He just takes his position in 3rd place. That spin was not doing. So Palmer back down to 4th place. Myers 5th, Armstrong 2nd, of course, got 1st. Jake 6th, 7th is Mike 8th. Is Collins, 9th Strickland, 10th AJ, 11th is Soja. Bartlett is 12th. 13th is Watson. Ebron is 14th in the garage. 15th, Juve. And Frankie in the final position as these guys get ready to do battle. In the last three laps of this race, this might get a little dangerous.
Green, 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 green.
And there's a green flag.
Oh, right, yellow flag. Back
whoa.
It down.
Car. Wow. That was unfortunate. I saw Gott start. I saw Armstrong. But that was it. I don't know if someone... I don't know what happened there. Fortunately, there is a multiple car incident at start, straight, finish. Start, finish, straight. And they bring it around. Bring it around town a few more times. To finish the last three laps. The last three laps of this 90-lap feature. Here at Sandusk. Ooh, and Hebron puts it in the garage, parks it. Hebron parks in the garage. After starting from 15th, Hebron was able to make his way all the way up to, I believe, 6th position. But unfortunately, he was not able to hold on. He may have not managed his tires that well, or had other problems with his vehicle. But that was a great run by him. Great show. Definitely has that pace. Has that pace. But needs that consistency to stay up there. It looks like we are actually missing... Ooh, and Ichi says put it has parked it. Ichi has parked it. After being on the podium for quite a while. Unfortunately, that puts Palmer on the podium. Coming up from a 7th position. Very low down. He's worked his way back up through the field. Myers in 4th position, coming from 11th, starting 11th, excuse me, he's in 4th position.
Green flag, go, 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 go!
Let's see what happened.
Alright, yellow flag, back it down.
As, I'm not sure what happened there, I believe that was a... One of the guys spun it at the beginning of the... green flag there. Still have to go into another yellow flag. Still 3 laps to go. Don't worry. And get this, Jake, currently in 5th position, started in 17th position. Now, I believe that may be the largest gain here at the moment. 17th to 5th, amazing job getting through the field.
Green, 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 green!
As they go green, yet again, with 2 laps to go, 1 lap to go. As they do this, Palmer looking for a pass on Armstrong. He spins Armstrong in the second to last lap. Sorry, the last lap, right before the finish line. Myers is able to finish in second, Jake in third. What an amazing job Jake does, starting from the final position. He's able to bring it home in third. That was awesome. Fourth, we have Mike from Mike B. Fifth, we have Mr. Collins. Sixth, Strickland. Seventh, Armstrong after that unfortunate spin at the end there. Eighth, AJ. Ninth, Palmer. Tenth, Bartlett. 11th is Watson making his way around. 12th is Soja. 13th, Hichis. 14th is Hebron and Dan. 15th, Neil. 16th, Frankie. In 17th position. What a great race. Those 60 laps, every single one of them were excellent. Now we're going to see if we could bring those guys from the podium into the broadcast booth here to get an interview, because those last few laps were quite something to talk about. Okay, it looks like we are there, actually confirming the finish there that we saw. I believe it was Armstrong and Palmer get mixed up while they're in second and third position and let Myers and Jake through to finish in second and third position, respectively, of course. So we'll see what's going on with that. Hopefully everything's okay. I believe the two drivers are okay, but we'll see what they have to say. Stick around. And here we have the podium, Scott, Myers, and Bartlett. How you guys doing?
Good.
Good.
Let's start with third place, Bartlett. Actually, third place and second place, Myers. Once you saw Armstrong and Palmer get into it on that very last turn, what went through your head, guys, Myers?
Stay as low as possible because I knew they were going off the track. With that being said, we've never really had an incident in the last lap of a feature. Normally the guy responsible will go to the tail, but with this one, we're not exactly sure. We're going to have to implement a new rule for next season, but anyhow, it was just shoot low and pray for the best.
And I saw the smoke and I saw the gap open up and Myers hit it. I just tried to follow him through.
Well, that was a nice job by both of you, as you guys did make it through and to the podium. What amazing luck you guys got there. Both of you, actually all of you, first, second, and third, came up from mid to lower pack there. Bartlett, how did you get up there and stay up there, if you could explain that for us?
Yeah, when the Mac Tools Deuce wasn't the fastest car on the track, we had maybe a top 10 car. I got a little worried there. My whole plan was to just keep my tires under me and try and work my way up through, but when I ended up 16th there, partway through, I got a little concerned, but I just stuck myself to the back of the Chris Myers vehicle and tried to follow him up through.
That's a nice job you did there, Myers. Was your strategy the same?
He's a man of few words.
I'm sorry, I didn't even catch it.
Was your strategy the same as Nelson's there?
Yeah, my strategy was really to go to the back, not as quick as I did, but the race pace was really, really quicker than I thought it was going to be. The car was phenomenal. The tires were phenomenal. I didn't start seeing it anywhere until 20 to go, and that's when I really started forcing the issue and picking off cars. But other than that, the car was phenomenal and just tried to bide my time, and new guys up front were using their stuff up, so the longer and longer I conserved my tires, I would be able to pick a couple cars off. But hats off to Shane. He ran a hell of a race, both races tonight. The guy living in Oregon, he's on the West Coast. He still runs with us, and he did a hell of a job. Hats off to him.
Yeah, Shane did an immaculate job. Shane got starting in 12th position, getting his way all the way up to the first position. Shane, how does that feel after seeing the first half of the race being dominated by Armstrong?
It's good. It's tough coming from that far back. But yeah, you just kind of wait for people to make some mistakes and take advantage.
That's some excellent stuff. Bartlett, do you have anybody you'd like to thank for tonight?
Myself.
Yeah, cool for me.
Myers?
For me, just want to thank the great group of guys we raced with here. Start off as a lead years ago, getting, you know, five or six guys last year, and now we're up to mid-20s. Guys had family commitments tonight, but, you know, just the admin team I worked with, AJ Truex, the owner of Up in Smoke Racing, Dave Soja, the head admin responsible for making a lot of the calls that you see here tonight, Art Palmer, one of my good buddies, and he does a lot of the stuff with social media and testing. And just, again, thanks to the great group of guys we have here. It's a pretty close-knit clan, and everybody's friends. You know, we're all competitive. We all share setups and help each other out. But when it comes down to race time, we're pretty competitive.
Yes, you guys are very competitive, and it shows amazing racing through the whole entire race. Shane, do you have any last words?
You know, just thank Up in Smoke for putting this stuff on. It's fun. I enjoy it.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jerry.
And thank you, everybody at home, for tuning in. Up in Smoke Racing. We're racing the Supermodifieds here at Lorain with 45-lap feature and at Sandusky with the 60-lap feature. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.